Good afternoon, everybody. It's nice to be here. Thank you for the invitation. Can I just put in an apology? As you will see on the program, Amy Davison was supposed also to be here, but unfortunately she got sick the day before yesterday, so she put in an apology. I will speak on behalf of the City of Cape Town and what we are doing there to become a sustainable city. Now, transitioning towards a more sustainable city is a process which requires some, and we've heard it today as well, important shifts in thinking. And the economy is a system which is embedded in society, both of which are embedded in the environment. Without a healthy, functional environment, people and the economy can't survive. You see there the quote from Dr. McPherson that if you really think the environment is less important than the economy, try holding your breath while you count your money. Now, there's no such thing as waste in a natural system. All the waste products become more resources for other parts of the system. And you will see the truck there, and I don't know if you can see there's some kind of banner on the truck, and that said that the sign that nature knows no waste, nor should we. We must reduce, reuse, recycle, and stop littering. Now, local government has a key role to play in driving sustainable transitions through sustainable procurement as well as appropriate policy. Now, on the photo, you will see the people busy with energy efficient lighting retrofit in the City of Cape Town's offices. Now, what is the City of Cape Town doing? In the first place, we amend and write relevant policies to include sustainable procurement and to promote the use of innovative technologies. And secondly, we implement innovative projects and programs. Now, the City of Cape Town policies in support of sustainable innovation and green procurement, I just mentioned some of the aims there is to encourage innovation in service delivery that would improve the way the city operates in the long term, to encourage innovation in stimulating the green economy, to promote and pilot innovative approaches to service delivery and project implementation that aim to prevent, minimize or mitigate environmental impacts, and encourage the implementation of innovative approaches in the broader city context. It also is there to support and drive the implementation of innovative technologies and the behavioral changes that promote resource efficiency. And it's also there to actively increase the city's own contribution to resource efficiency through directed green procurement. We also amend the policies and management practices to support the testing of the new technologies. We actively work towards achieving improved resource efficiency by promoting innovation in service delivery, building resource efficiency requirements into development proposals, and we also integrate spatial planning and transport planning in the city. It's also to investigate and implement innovative technologies to sustainably manage water and wastewater, also encourage and invest in new and existing innovative and locally relevant low carbon and climate resilient technologies and approaches, many of which can save money in the long term. And then it also considers the life cycle costs of goods and services in the city's supply chain management processes, thereby promoting the use of climate appropriate resources, technologies and approaches, and stimulating the market for these products and services which focus on local supply where available. I can just say that in our procurement policy, we also have a clause on community vendor base. So there are people out of the community, certain tenders, when they put out, It's specifically for community and people in communities to tender for. And that helped a lot. Now, I will just show you some of Cape Town sustainable innovation projects. The one is efficiency, electricity efficiency. We already retrofit all our offices with high efficiency LEDs. All the traffic lights with LEDs. We also retrofit street lights with energy saving low pressure sodium lamps. And we also changes to computer powering setting profiles. And that save a lot of money to the city. When we look at water efficiency, we also have the zone metering and the pressure reduction, which is ability to reduce water pressure in areas with incidences of leaks to reduce wastage and cost for end users. And then we also have the integrated water leaks project, which is an innovative approach to reducing wastage by training community plumbers. There's communities have plumbers, and we train them to identify and fix simple plumbing leaks in low-income households for a small fee, so that is also a job creation. And then if we look at waste, we have the integrated waste exchange, which is an online platform for businesses to connect with others in the value chain. And then we also have the Kraaifontein Materials Recovery Facility, which is a flagship for sorting of clean recyclables, chipping of green waste for compost, and also operated by contractors and sold for profit. And then we also partner with Green Cape. Transport, we are already put in an order for 10 electric buses as part of the MyCity fleet, which is a shift towards the solar PV for charging. And then Wallace Dean is a big informal settlement there in the metro, and there we put up a green taxi rank, which is solar powered, and rainwater harvesting and recycling is also on the site. Transport innovations, we have linear quarries, which is the use of materials for roads resurfacing by careful stockpiling of old layers in the deconstruction process. And then also we have a shift to warm mix asphalt as a lower energy, healthier and safer innovative technology. You can see the bus there that asphalt is because of that innovation. Building innovations, there's two projects in Ocean View. It's also a big housing project in the city where we use naturally occurring nuisance rocks on the site as building materials. And we're also using traditional stone masonry methods. And then Delft is also a big project there in near Kelsriver, where we built an early childhood development center. And the innovation there is the approach to using alternative building materials and methods, such as earth bricks and waste products, such as tires and bottles, to complete that. Now, what is the next steps in the city of Cape Town? We want to finalize and get approval from our council of a City of Cape Town Green Procurement Action Plan, because we're already using that, but to get all the departments on board and to have a policy for that. And then also our key focus of green procurement and innovative technology adoption into the future will be water efficiency and water savings. As you all know, the city at this present moment, we have the severest drought in history. And then we also want to carry on with our implementation of innovative projects. With that, it's the end of my story. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.